Testing. Testing, testing. Okay, got it. Good morning. Good morning, Bethany School. How are you? Good. We have a lot of visitors here today because it is a special chapel. It is our awards chapel, and so we get to celebrate the students who have gone above and beyond academically. And if your name is not called today, that is okay. You can take this new semester to get started and to dig deep and do better academically. So we're going to start with thanking our tech crew. I know Amy Coffey's out today, so I see Dana Stewart and middle school boys. They're waving their hands in the back. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. And let's get started with our pledges. Third grade is coming up for pledges. Come on up if you've been selected, as well as our student council chaplain, Coraline. Would everyone please stand?
Who's doing Bible? Oh, it's an American flag.
Okay. Please, please put your hands over your right heart and please pledge to the American flag. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the American flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please pledge to the Christian flag. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen and coming again, with life and liberty for all who believe.
Please pledge to the Holy Bible. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its word to my heart that I might not sin against God.
Please pray with me. Dear Jesus, thank you for today. Thank you that we could all come and have another wonderful day at Bethany. Please help us all to have integrity for others and to encourage each other. And please put your hand over our school and help us all to be safe today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let's give them a round of applause, our third graders and our student council chaplain. So, if everyone could get seated, we're going to get started with our BBSN announcements.
Good morning, Bethany School. I'm Amin Tua.
And I'm Kaylee Hill.
What a fun chapel we had last week with our moms and mom figures.
Yeah, your mom has jokes.
She is pretty punny.
We want to give a big welcome to all the parents, grandparents, and other loved ones in the audience today.
Yes, today we're celebrating the success of many of our Bethany students this quarter.
Thank you, really, for this award. I am so honored.
This is how it's done. I am humbled by your gracious applause, and I would like to thank you for
Bethany students, don't miss your last shot at going to a Clippers game. They're playing the Lakers. It's going to be a really good game.
Kaylee and I are sorry for getting carried away with our award speeches.
Yeah, we were on a roll.
In other news, Bethany, open house is just a few weeks away.
Yes, it will be a glowing night, shining a spotlight on all your hard work this year, Bethany. See you March 2nd at 6 p.m.
Here's Sadie with a sweet reminder. Over to you, Sadie.
Thanks, Amy and Kaylee. Bethany students, Student Council is continuing to sell donuts and water for $2. They're raising money for a leadership conference at Disneyland. Back to you, Amin and Kaylee.
Thank you, Sadie. Those donuts are delicious.
Hey, Amin, how do you catch a whole school of fish?
How?
With bookworms, of course.
Ha ha, you caught me off guard with that one.
I had you reeling. Speaking of books, the book fair is coming March 13th to the 17th.
Don't miss your chance to power up on some new books, Bethany.
Here's Trey and Mark with another important reminder.
Bethany, next week is the 100th day of school.
Heh, the 100th day? That's almost as old as you.
Heh.
I say you're old.
Heh, I'm not even one day over 100.
Well, it says here we're supposed to remind you all to dress like 100 years old next Wednesday, February 26th. I don't see what's so fun about that.
Yes, it's hard work being 100. I can barely hear you, and you all look like dots on the screen. And my back is...
Oh, ah! Have you seen my grandson?
Wow, what a show.
Yes, definitely entertaining. Bethany, don't forget, no school Monday, February 20th.
Yes, in honor of President's Day. Thanks, George Washington.
This is Miss Pam coming to you live from the Walmart department store. No, not really. This is Bethany's Lost and Found. As you can see, we have an array of a collection of your children's belongings. We're asking you, one, to put your kid's name on. Two, get out of the car. Fellowship with us around the Lost and Found and pick up your kid's belonging. Thank you so much for your cooperation.
Well, that about wraps up our show for today. Thank you. Remember, it's always a good day to be a Bulldog.
This has been a production of the Bethany Bulldog School News. I'm Mrs. Hill, and I approve this message.
Great job. Great job, middle school. Those are our middle school students, and Mrs. Rory Slater and Miss Pam. And those are a lot of clothes there that are hanging on that wall. If you don't pick them up at a certain point, we're going to give them all to the Long Beach Rescue Mission. So it's going to a worthy cause, whether it's your child or the Long Beach Rescue Mission. Somebody's going to enjoy it. All right. Our 100th day of school, again, is next Wednesday, I believe. And the staff and I participate in a 100th day of school, a 100th day of school race. And it's become a tradition and a lot of fun. So hopefully parents will be able to be there with us. As you know, we're celebrating 75 years of Christian education in the community. And we will be celebrating in April. You should have received a flyer of some sort. But while we're celebrating 75 years, we are respectful to honor others that are celebrating 75 years. So let's see what Mrs. Stewart has for us today.
Hello and welcome to History Pod. On the 26th of July 1948, President Harry S. Truman issued Executive Order 9981 that abolished racial segregation in the US military. Although African Americans had made significant contributions to the armed forces, stretching right back to the American Revolution, the uniformed military remained segregated throughout the Second World War. While the foundations of military desegregation had been laid when President Franklin D. Roosevelt issued Executive Order 8802 to end segregation in the civil defense industry, black volunteers in the military were usually given combat support roles and a lengthy delay before beginning combat training. Therefore, before the war had even ended, the military found itself under pressure to address the issue of racial segregation from organizations such as the NAACP and individuals, including the First Lady, Eleanor Roosevelt. A survey of 250 white officers and sergeants conducted shortly after the conclusion of the war in 1945 returned results that were favorable towards integration. And this was followed by an April 1946 review that concluded the military should seek to eliminate any special consideration based on race. The following year, the President's Committee on Civil Rights published a separate report that proposed a wide range of equality legislation alongside an end to all discrimination and segregation based on race, color, creed, or national origin in the military. Partly to avoid opposition to the proposed changes in the Senate, Truman abolished racial segregation in the US military by issuing Executive Order 9981. Although there was initial opposition from the Army, casualties in the Korean War meant that integration was soon necessary, and by October 1953, an estimated 90% of black soldiers had been integrated.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Stewart. Celebrating 75 years of desegregation in our U.S. military, as well as it being Black History Month. And we are reflective of a melting pot of our Long Beach area, and so very proud to stand here and represent my school and our community. All right, we are going to praise the Lord with Mrs. Robin Rivers. We have a new song that we learned last week with Mom's Muffin Day in chapel, if you were here last week. But let's bring up Mrs. Rivers. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Good morning, Bethany School. Can we all stand to our feet? My middle school dancers are gonna head on up. Are we all awake this morning? Yes. Run on up, run on up, run, run, run. Let's put the twin power in the middle. Right here, twin power. Right here. Okay, we're ready. Are we all spread out?
It's a new day, and I'm feeling so alive with you. I'm feeling so alive with you. You're making all things brand new. So crazy to believe that nothing's ever gonna come between all the love that you have for me. It's a new day. Faces.
Good job. Right. Wait, we got to do our encouragement song. Are you ready to encourage them? All right, here we go. Come on, Jaden.
Oh God, I know you're always near. So even in the dark, I will not fear. I know the storm.
Let me hear you. I won't be.
I won't be afraid. I won't even worry. Cause you've got the whole world in your hands. You fight for me. You help me stand. You make me brave. You give me courage.
Great job, Mrs. Rivers, in middle school. If you didn't know, visitors, our word for the year is encourage. And we talk about encouraging one another, what it looks like. Sometimes it's cheering on our sports department, our athletes. Sometimes it's just sitting next to someone who's not feeling well and putting our arm around them. And sometimes we encourage each other when we pray. So we sing that song every Friday. Courage. Well, I know a lot of you are like, when are we going to get to the awards chapel? We're going to get to it right now. This is Mrs. Diane Golden, and give her a round of applause. She's going to help me as we get these awards out to our deserving students. And we're going to start with academic effort. Yes, those of you who have really tried and made a change academically since the beginning of the school year, and it was reflective in your grades, academic effort. And we're going to begin with Jameson Gomez. Come on up. Gabriel Hernandez, come on up. James Ramirez, come on up. James Ramirez, is he here? Oh, okay, all right. Oh, I like how you're encouraging. Kennedy Thompson, come on up. Samuel Mack, come on up. Samuel Mack. Parker Lance, come on up, Parker. Nyla Harbor, come on up. Taylor Hendricks, come on up. Mason Thurston, come on up. Luna DeRozier, come on up. Xander Hamilton, come on up. Ryan Stevenson, get on up here. Good job, Ryan. Halea Loyola, come on up. Come on up, Halea. And Jaden Combs, come on up for academic effort. All right, great job. Great job for academic effort. Now we're moving on to academic achievement. We're going to begin with Gage Cox, Taj Dawkins, Jeremiah Cave, Joshua Morales, Benjamin Fay, Avery Miller, Sarah Komenchek, Caitlin McGee, Josiah Hill, there's another Fay, Rebecca Fay, come on up. Brooklyn Helsper, Avery Hamilton, and Malia Williams. Come on up. Academic achievement.
Thank you.
Okay, next we are moving on to what was very important for me when my children went here. Years ago, I knew that they would learn academically. I knew that they would be leaders, but Christian conduct meant more than anything. It demonstrates that you show morals and godly principles, and you just try to do your best to be more like Christ. So for Christian conduct, which is my all-time favorite, Presley Newman, come on up. Leonardo Flores, come on up. Ava Williams, come on up. Enrique Kiki Cano, come on up. Layla Ramirez, come on up. Emily Nesbitt, come on up. Asaya Lopez, come on up. Gunnar Newman, come on up. Gwendolyn Safer, where are you? Come on up. Penelope Siegfried, come on up. Emma Ward, come on up. Quentin Evans, come on up. Hudson Rivers, come on up. And Amarachi and Jumanze, come on up. These are the recipients of Christian conduct. Okay, yeah, Enrique said, it's my first time. So excited for him. All right, we are moving on to honor roll. Students who have a grade point average of 3.5 to 3.9. Big deal, we're gonna start with Eden Jurado. Come on up. Mr. Newman, Gunnar Newman, come on up. Jonathan Twall, come on up, Jonathan. Carter Cave, come on up. Miss Skylar Dumas, come on up. Caitlin McGee, come on up. Harlem Thomas, come on up. Mr. Thurston, Mason Thurston, come on up. Ariel Davis, come on up. Back at Bethany, Jasmine Healy, come on up. Caden Miller, come on up. Ja Watson, come on up. Madison DeBose, come on up. Xander Hamilton, come on up. Jonathan Johnson, come on up. Xavier Johnson, come on up. A lot of students on honor roll. Darren Mang, come on up. Sebastian Picas, come on up. Liam Romero, come on up. Quentin Evans, new to Bethany, come on up. Brooklyn Helsper, come on up. Kaylee Hill, our news anchor, come on up. Malachi James, come on up. Brooke Veazey, come on up. Mr. Guidry, Mark Guidry, come on up. Avery Hamilton, come on back up. From the sound booth, Jonathan Barroso, come on. Jaden Combs, come on up. Mackenzie Coet, come on up. And Malia Williams, come on up. These are our students with a GPA of 3.5 to 3.9, working very hard. You guys can't hear what we hear.
Oh, it's my first time.
It's his first time. Is it your first time? Is it your first time? Oh my goodness. You know, we changed the curriculum. This is our second year using Savvis curriculum, and it is very challenging. I heard from all of you wonderful parents about the language arts, but specifically the math. They've been doing it. It's been challenging. Don't ask me. I would get a tutor for my child. It's just like that. But they have been doing a great job. Can you see everyone, Mrs. Smoot? Okay, thank you. Be careful. Thank you. There's a jacket down here. I don't know who that belongs to. Okay.
Do you remember the date of our spelling bee?
March 21st.
Okay. Okay, before we do our last awards, Mrs. Golden reminded me that our spelling bee is March 21st, excuse me, and last year we brought back the spelling bee because we just wanted to try to get things back to normal here at Bethany, especially with the students, and so a lot of schools had not resumed, a lot of the private schools had not resumed the spelling bee. So this year, Cindy Jarvis, she's the principal at Santa Fe Springs. She said, you guys did the spelling bee last year. Can our school join yours? We said, absolutely. So they're bringing their top students here, and we already have selected our top students. And although it is not a competition, Bethany students, we are going to bring it, and we're going to blow them out the water. Do you hear me? Yes. So I'll have my boxing gloves on March 21st, and we're just really excited about that. Moving on to our last awards, it is for the principal's list, and these students have a 4.0. Yeah. If you did not get one of these, it is okay, keep doing your best. I didn't get a 4.0 until high school and in college. So if you're starting here, where else do you go, right? Let's begin with Taylor Hendricks. Come on up. Sarah Komenchek, come on up. Odara Majay, come on up. Aubrey Nixon, come on up. Mr. Jack Schaefer, come on up. Keegan Hamilton, come on up. Antonio Barovinos, come on up. Connor Curtis, come on up. Luna DeRozier, come on up. Mr. Hill, Josiah Hill, come on up. Ikenna Injimanse, come on up. Our student council chaplain, Corlin Smoot, come on up. Mr. Stefan, Josh Stefan, come on up. Our violinist, Theo Ventura, come on up. Student Council Representative Emily Weigel, come on up. I knew there'd be another Faye. Rebecca Faye, come on up here. Harper Coet. I call her Harp Harp. Come on up, Harper Coet, our little dancer. New to Bethany this year, Jai Pankey, come on up. Levi Provenzano, come on up. All 4.0, Malia Ramirez, come on up. Emma Ward, come on up. Our other news anchor, Amin Twal, come on up. Hudson Rivers, come on up. News anchor, Sadie Vanderspeck, come on up. Hopefully you're able to come to the varsity girls basketball game yesterday. They are undefeated. They are amazing. One of their players, Amarachi Injimanse, come on up. She was killing it yesterday. And our student council president, Maya Stefan, come on up.
Thank you.
So just a reminder, we have our open house on March 2nd. That's a Thursday. Our book fair is coming up. 100 Days of School next Wednesday. We are celebrating 75 years of excellence at Bethany School. And I'm just grateful that you all came. I'm going to say a prayer, and then we'll have Miss Rivers come up, and we're going to sing our school song, and then we are dismissed for a three-day weekend. Do not show up on Monday. Not even Frankie will be here on Monday. So let's bow our heads in prayer. Father God, we thank you for today. Your word says this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I'm so thankful that this year our word is to encourage, Father God. I pray for my parents that have made the choice to have their students here this year at Bethany. And Lord, that you would encourage them, Father God, to be the best parents that they can be. Create a community around their children, Father God, that would pour into their children's lives and partner with their views as well. I thank you for my staff. I'm so grateful for their consistency with the students, Father God, and for Mrs. Golden and my team, Lord, that you help us to get up every day and be an example of you, and that you continue to bless the works of our hands, and that we continue to work in excellence. Bless the rest of this day. May we become more like you, and help us to have a relaxing three-day weekend. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, Mrs. Rivers, everyone stand.
Please join me in our school song. We are the students of Bethany School, and we grow each day in God's grace. Step by step and day by day, we learn, we play, and praise you in this place. We are focused on our future, and God's guiding our way. We're walking in our purpose, and we will not stray. We, the students of Bethany School, are future-focused indeed.
Do not leave. Where is Miss Pam? Come on up real quick, family. I want you to know about this. I mentioned it before. It was on Miss Pam's heart for us to have a prayer box. It was on her heart, and now we finally have it, and she's put into place how it's going to work for our school. Miss Pam, come on up. Give her a round of applause.
Good morning, guys. I'm going to just say this. In the black church, when we're going through something, we just walk up and say, pray for me. So right now, I'm going to just ask you guys to make sure that you pray for me today. But my announcement is about the prayer box that we've implemented here at Bethany. Here at Bethany, we care for the whole family. It's not just dropping your students off so we can watch them and educate them. We know that you have lives. And sometimes your lives can be overwhelming, and they can be stressful, and they can be difficult. And your kids are going through things that we don't often know what they're going through at home and in their lives outside of this campus. So we wanted to implement a prayer box so that you can just put your prayers in, and we can commit to praying for those things. We don't have to have your name. The box is going to be located in the daycare room when you pick up your child, or at the gate. When I'm at the gate, the box will be there with me. Feel free to walk up, write down what you want, stick it in the box, and we'll commit to praying for you, whatever that is, because God says we are to pray without ceasing. Does that mean you walk around with your eyes closed praying? No, it's in everything that you're going through throughout your day. You stop and you pray, whether it's thanking God, asking God, blessing God, worshiping God, praising God, you pray. So we want to make sure that we're praying for you. We're not just a Christian school in name only. We are to be followers of Christ, and he prays for us. He is sitting at the right hand of the Father making intercession for us as I speak. So make sure that if you have any prayer requests, to put those in the box, and we'll commit here at Bethany to pray for you. Amen? All right.
Thank you. You're dismissed. Thank you.